Thanks, dancers Anthony Rose, and welcome back to our West Coast Swing Secret Series. Now, yes. In this part, we're covering the whip patterns. And notice I said the whip patterns because there's the basic whip, and then we're gonna show you guys a bunch of different ways to do that. And again, this is part four of the series, so make sure you watch the first three before covering this one. Now, if you're brand new here at the channel, we cover all the country dances, obviously from West Coast Swing to two-step to waltz to polka, but you're gonna notice a little button down here, and it says subscribe. Now, if you click that button, then you become an X-dancer, and you'll know when all the awesome stuff happens here on the channel. So we're gonna demonstrate the basic idea of the whip, and then we'll break it down. All right, guys, we're gonna demonstrate the basic whip, show you guys a few variations that we're gonna talk about today, and then we'll actually start breaking this stuff down. So we have 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So it's an 8-count pattern now. This is a whip with an underarm turn. So we have a whip with an outside turn. We can even do a whip with a behind-the-back hand change. Obviously, guys, there's a whole bunch of different variations that we can do to the whip. This is ongoing and never ending. So let's break down the basic whip. Guys, everything we've done up to this point has been 6-count patterns. You know, we did the side passes, we did the rolling passes, we did the sugar push. They all had the same count. Now at this point, we're getting into a different rhythm. So instead of a 6-count pattern, this is an 8-count pattern. And by the way, if you're watching this video and you've not done the other stuff first, click that link right there, because that stuff right there is more important than this. Like, it graduates into this. And if you start at this point, it's just gonna be probably a little confusing. So here's the basic idea of an 8-count pattern. Now, in a 6-count pattern, what we talked about before is she starts over there and she goes over there, right? I'm moving side to side. So when we do 6-count patterns, she starts over there and I send her to the other side. And there's a bunch of different ways that we can do this stuff, but she essentially just goes from one side to the next. Now, as far as the motion of an 8-count pattern, she goes to that other side and then she goes back. So she starts over here, she goes to that circle, and then she goes back. So if you watch this again, she starts over here, she goes to that side, but then I send her back to the original spot. Now, we do have an extra 2 counts in order to do that. So instead of 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, and 6, which is your 6-count pattern, you have 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now we have 5, 6, 7, and 8. So it's walk, walk, triple step, walk, walk, triple step. Now, the way that we've broken this down before is in four sections, I'm sorry, it was 3 sections, 2 beats of music. Now we have 4 sections. The good news is the first 2 counts of every pattern, whether it's a 6-count pattern or an 8-count pattern, it always is the same thing. She comes towards me. Okay. Now, in this pattern, I'm actually going to give her a little bit of what's called a J hook, which means I take her down and I curve the hand a little bit, which creates some rotation. Now, we teach this as a half of a turn between counts 1 and 2 for the follower. So if you watch this, she steps forward for 1, then she does a quarter of a turn and I pick her up under the arm. All right. Now, if you look, I've basically done a quarter of a turn. She's done a quarter of a turn because we're facing this direction. And when I pick her up, we're both essentially facing the side, all right? Now, I wanna say something here, because West Coast Swing is not a this is in the box and correct pattern. There's more than one concept. There are different teachers teach this slightly different. Ultimately, the overall thing is the same, but you're gonna see some slight variance of when she turns and how much she turns. I'm not saying either one is wrong. It's just we teach what we dance. So we have 1, 2. Now, at this point, my hand is on her shoulder blade. Now I've gotten into section 2. The concept of section 2 is I send her over there for 3 and then I start her back. All right, so you've got 4 separate intentions or sections. Each one has a separate thing to do. In the first 2 beats, she starts coming towards me. The second 2 beats, she starts coming back. So if you watch this from this side, she comes towards me and then I start sending her back. So she comes towards me, then I start sending her back. We need to talk about that footwork. Guys, we are having so much fun doing these videos for you guys. We hope you guys are learning stuff. But you know what we love even more than this? We love seeing you guys and teaching you guys and meeting you guys in person.
It's the best. We are having so much fun, seriously. Just seeing everybody is awesome.
We're literally on tour right now, and I bet you there's a location near you. So click that link right there, see where we're gonna be at. If we're somewhere close to you, we'd love to have you out. Now back to your video. So leaders, again, there's more than one way to do this. This is the way we dance this. We're gonna step slightly back and to the side for 1, and then we pull our feet together for count 2. Now that I've said that, you're gonna see a lot of people that step back into the side and they begin to cross on count two. Either, I'm not saying it's wrong, it's just for the purpose of this video, you can step back and then you step together. Notice I've turned a quarter of a turn. This is section one. Then we're gonna step in place. We're off to the side of the slot for three, and then on count four, I'm gonna turn a quarter of a turn to my right and step all the way across the slot. So if I show you this from this angle, that's one, two, three, and quarter turn, four. So for the follower's footwork, she steps forward for one, and then she turns a quarter of a turn to step to the side for two. Now her momentum is continually traveling in that direction, so she's gonna turn another quarter of a turn to step back. She steps together, and when I step across, she steps forward and between my feet. So if we watch that from this side, that's one, there's a quarter turn, there's another quarter, she steps together, and then she steps forward. So if we watch that again, she comes towards me, I send her over there, and I start bringing her back for count four. Now, one thing we gotta talk about is what's called elasticity or stretch. You're gonna have that, basically, if you take a rubber band and I pulled it this way, that's elasticity. You got her and I, we're stretching away from each other. In a whip pattern, we stretch, we release it, but then she gets a stretch on the other side before she comes back. So you've got stretch over here, we switch sides, and now it's stretched, and then it moves back. So if you watch that from here, she is stretched over in this side, but when she gets over there, she's got some amount of stretch there for me to bring her back. Now, the rhythm of this is one, two, three, and four, and then we enter section three. Now, I'm gonna tell you what the intention of section three is. Section three is some stuff happens. That's the variation.
What kind of stuff?
Section one is always she comes towards me. Section two is always she starts moving back. Section three, that's the variation, okay? Now in this case, we're just gonna show you the basic, no turn, no nothing. She's just gonna walk through that section as she's moving back. So if you watch, one, two, we have the stretch for three, and I start sending her back for four, and then we have quarter, quarter turn. I pull my feet together as she turns quarter, I step into the slot as she steps back for another quarter turn, and then we'll end up doing the section four. But the footwork for that is walk, walk, triple step, walk, walk, and then we do a triple step. Yep. So it's walk, walk, triple step, then walk, walk, and then we do a triple step. Now, I'm assuming you did because you're here. You watched the other three videos. The last two beats of every section or every pattern, that last section, is going to be a triple in place, also called an anchor. So that's still the same in an eight count pattern. It just replaced, it's just now in the fourth section rather than the third. So she comes towards me, she comes back, there's a walk, walk, and now we have an anchor and stretch, okay? So when we talk about these four sections, every eight count pattern is structured in that way to where she comes towards me, she starts moving back, you have the variation, and then you have the anchor. So any new thing you learn in an eight count pattern, like a whip pattern, that variation happens in that third section, which is that second set of walk, walk. So if you watch these variations again, and we'll break down some of these, but she comes towards me, she comes back, now here's your variation, and there's your anchor. So now we have, she comes towards me, she comes back, there's the variation underarm turn, and there's the anchor. Everything's the same for section one, section two, outside turn for section three, and then we have the anchor. That's the structure of an eight count pattern, okay?
Makes it more simple.
Yeah, so really you're just learning a section of two beats of music where the stuff happens. So what we gotta do is decide as a leader which one of those things do we wanna do for section three. What stuff do we wanna do? So we watch that again. She should know at the end of section two probably what is going to happen to some degree in section three. We're letting her know something's gonna happen, right? So she comes towards me for one, two, then we have three, and. Now if I keep the hand down and I do this, chances are we're just doing a base hit because I'm just gonna rotate the body. If I want to lead a different variation for section three, I bring the hand up, put it into that halo that goes around her head, and we're going to go one, two, three, and. Now, if I bring the hand up and point the hand inwards, that's an underarm turn. So for that next section, she's going to go walk, walk under the turn, or under the arm, and then we have the anchor. With an outside, I just position the hand differently, one, two, three, and four. Now she's turning outside for five, six, and then we do our anchor. So instead of learning eight count patterns and all this stuff, you gotta learn each individual thing, you're just taking that one section of two beats of music and having that as a variation from one pattern
Make
to the
fancy.
Next.
Yep.
All right? Now, a lot of times when people get to this point and they start working on WHIP patterns, and they've got this rhythm that's a six count and a rhythm that's an eight count, they really have a hard time determining, is this, how do I know? How do I know whether something is switching back and forth? Like, I was doing six count, but now how am I gonna know that now this is an eight count? And the answer is really, really simple.
Yeah.
We already told you, but we need to make this clear. If she goes from this side of the slot and she passes me and she ends up over there and I leave her there, that's the six count pattern. However, if I take her to the other side and then say, nope, you need to go back in the middle of the pattern, in order to get her back to the other side, we have to add that walk, walk in between to give her a couple more counts to move.
That'll be your eight count.
Now, if the rhythm is changing in section three, so in a six count pattern, I'll show you what's called a half whip. And this is a really great pattern to learn the difference between a six and an eight. In a half whip, she goes one, two, three, and four, five, and six. Okay, what happened was, is I took her into that position as if I was going to do that whip pattern, but I didn't bring her back. I let her stay on the new side, right? So if we watch that again, we have one, two, three, and stay over there, five and six. Everything up to count four is exactly the same. So watch this again, one, two, three, and. One, two, three, and. It is count four that lets her know.
Crucial moment.
If it's a six or an eight. If it's a six count pattern, she's got to stay on that side. So I leave her over there for count six or count four, and then I can do the five and six. If it's an eight count pattern, I'll get to one, two, three, and she doesn't stay anymore. I need to bring her towards me to start sending her back. So count four of an eight count or six count pattern will determine what the rhythm is next. So let me show you this again. If I take her from here to there and I leave her there, that is a six count pattern. If I take her over here and begin to send her back, chances are that's an eight count pattern.
Yep.
I've got to let her know at the end of section two what the rhythm is going to be in section three. Right?
Yep, makes sense.
So on count four is the end of section two. So we have one, two, three, and stay. Okay, five and six. Or we have one, two, three, and go. Five, six, seven, and eight, okay? Now that is not just for whip patterns, a lot of variations. So we can do things like this. One, two, three, come back. And she goes back to that other side, right? But if I take her over there and leave her over there, that's a six. Now there's a lot of other patterns. One, two, three, I bring her back for four, five and six, seven and eight, okay? If she goes from here, stays there, stays count. If she goes here and goes back, it's an eight, okay?
Definitely.
Watch all this stuff again. I spoke really fast. I said a lot of things.
It was
but the
a lot
thing
of stuff
you gotta
to
know,
fill your brain with.
The end of section two will let her know what's going to happen in section three. I want to show you a couple of these hand changes up close to these variations so that you can kind of mix this up and create new whip patterns. All right, guys, so really what we have to talk about here again is count four. On count four, I'm going to let her know she's going to do something, right? So if we get to count four, if I bring her towards me for one, two, three, and. On count four, this is gonna determine what's gonna happen next. So if I step across the slot and I keep that hand down, chances are I'm just bringing her to me so that I can send her out. Now, if I get to count four and I bring the hand up, chances are she wants, you know, I want her to go under it. But the position of the arm is gonna determine which direction she's gonna go. So if whenever I step across, I bring the hand up on count four, not on count five, on count four, if my fingertips are pointing inwards, which means they're pointing towards Rose, the chances are I want her to go underneath that arm for an underarm turn. Now, if we show you that again and we get to count four, one, two, three, and on count four, bring the hand up, but my fingertips are pointing outwards, chances are I want her to turn outwards in the direction of my fingertips for an outside turn. Now, if I want to do something like a behind the back hand change, I am going to keep the hand down, but I'm going to rotate her at a different angle. So we have one, two, three, and on four, I start to step around and start moving that hand behind her back and handing it off so that she can roll through. Either way, something happens on count four to determine the difference between what's going to happen, what is going to happen on count five, six. All right, so if we watch these to music, pay attention to count four and where my hand goes. So we have one, two, three, it stays down and she just turns out. Now if I bring it up and point it inwards, it's an inside like underarm turn. If I bring the hand up and turn it outwards, I'm turning her in that direction. Now, if I wanna do behind the back hand change, I gotta start bringing the hand behind her back. Now again, guys, there's an infinite number of whip variations. The thing you gotta know is usually something different on section three, okay? That's the difference between one pattern and next. Now in a six count pattern, obviously, section two is a variation. So if you guys have questions, this is a lot of information in just a short period of time in a video, leave comments down below. We wanna answer you guys' questions.
What would you guys like to see here on the channel too?
Right? The next video that we're going to be doing is what we call the wrap in and out, and there's a bunch of different variations for that. So we'll see you guys in that next video. Again, if you guys have questions, let us know, and thank you guys for watching. All right, congratulations, guys. You guys have now graduated. You've learned your eight count patterns. You've learned the whips. Woo! And the next step is going to be the wrap in and out. Those are right here for the next series. Or if you'd like to just watch another video here on YouTube, that's down here. And we'll see you guys next time.